Number 5. Voyagers is a science fiction thriller film released in 2021, directed by Neil Berger. The story is set in the future and follows a group of young people sent on a space expedition to explore a new planet to ensure their survival. They undergo genetic modifications, but as time progresses, their emotions and behaviors begin to change as the exploration unfolds. Tensions and personal journeys within the team come to the surface, leading to a series of conflicts and perilous situations. The film delves into themes of humanity, free will, and moral dilemmas arising from environmental shifts, all with strong psychological and emotional layers.
I need to protect them.
There's a toxin in the water. It's coming from us. We're eating something toxic.
It's the blue.
It's medication.
Blue.
To decrease pleasure.
Blue. I'm not drinking it.
What does it feel like to feel something?
You're not feeling what I'm feeling.
What's going on?
They're drugging us. Drugging us.
To prevent exactly this kind of thing from happening.
Yeah! System restarting.
We won't ever see the planet.
I want to be honest with them. About everything.
He can't protect you.
Protect us from what?
Let go!
Scared.
There's nothing to be scared of.
It's all in your...
Number 4. Passengers is a science fiction romance film released in 2016, directed by Morten Tildum. The story is set on a spacecraft transporting thousands of people to a distant colony planet. However, two passengers, Jim and Aurora, wake up prematurely from their hibernation pod, facing the daunting reality of being alone together for the duration of the journey. As they try to make the best of their situation and form a connection, they discover that there is a troubling reason behind their awakening. The film explores themes of isolation, companionship, ethical dilemmas, and the complexities of human relationships in a futuristic setting.
120 years hibernation means we'll wake up in a new century on a new planet. But a year ago, everything changed.
Hello? Anybody here?
Hello? Do you know what's going on? Nobody else is awake.
I think something went wrong with the hibernation pods. We woke up too soon. 9 years too soon.
This can't be happening. We have to go back to sleep.
We can't.
Aurora, we love you!
Something's wrong. Something big.
What do we do now?
Do you trust me? This ship is gonna go. I have to do this.
No! You die, I die!
There's something I have to tell you. There's a reason we woke up early.
Number 3. Gravity is a 2013 space thriller film directed by Alfonso Cuarón. The story follows Dr. Ryan Stone, a medical engineer, and astronaut Matt Kowalski as they find themselves stranded in space after their space shuttle is destroyed by debris from a satellite collision. With communication lost and limited resources, they must navigate the vastness of space to reach the safety of the International Space Station. The film showcases their struggle for survival in the harsh and unforgiving environment of outer space, exploring themes of isolation, resilience, and the fragility of human life in the vastness of the cosmos.
GPS is down. I can't.
Give me a visual.
I told you nothing. I see nothing.
You have a visual of Explorer.
No.
You have a visual of ISS.
No.
You need to focus. Anything. It's the sun and the earth. Give me coordinates.
I can't breathe.
You're burning oxygen. You have to sip, not gulp.
So where's home, Dr. Stone?
Lake Zurich, Illinois.
Is there somebody down there looking up, thinking about you?
I had a daughter. A little girl with brown hair. Tell her that I'm not quitting.
Number 2. The Martian is a gripping science fiction film released in 2015 and directed by Ridley Scott. Adapted from the novel by Andy Weir, the movie tells the story of astronaut Mark Watney, portrayed by Matt Damon, during a manned mission to Mars. An unexpected storm forces the crew to evacuate, leaving Watney behind, presumed dead. However, he survives the storm and finds himself stranded alone on the inhospitable planet. With limited supplies and communication, Watney faces the daunting challenge of staying alive until rescue is possible. He uses his ingenuity and expertise as a botanist to grow food, generate water, and signal Earth. Meanwhile, NASA and his fellow crew members work tirelessly to bring him back home.
Another mission to reach me. And I'm in a hat designed to last 31 days. So I gotta make water and grow food on a planet where nothing grows. But if I can't figure out a way to make contact with NASA, then none of this matters anyway.
We've got an incoming message.
Mein Gott.
Mark Watney is still alive.
Woo! In your face, Neil Armstrong. There must be some kind of way out of here. Okay, so let's do the math. I have enough food to last for 50 days.
He's going to starve to death long before we can help.
So, I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this.
He's 50 million miles away from home. He's totally alone. What the hell is he thinking right now?
I am the greatest botanist on this planet.
I know how to save Mark Watney.
But we need the Hermes crew.
We either have a high chance of killing one or a low chance of killing six.
I'm not risking their lives. It's bigger than one person.
No. It's not.
NASA rejected the mission.
So if we do this?
We're talking mutiny. If anything goes wrong, we die.
Do you realize how crazy this is?
We have no other option.
No matter what happens, tell the world, tell my family, that I never stop fighting to make it home.
Number 1. Interstellar is a science fiction film released in 2014, directed by Christopher Nolan. The movie is set in a future where Earth is facing extinction due to climate disasters and a food crisis, and follows the journey of former NASA pilot Cooper, played by Matthew McConaughey, who is chosen to lead a mission to find a new habitable planet for humanity, with Earth's survival in jeopardy. Cooper and a team of scientists and astronauts embark on a mission aboard the spacecraft Endurance. They travel through a wormhole to a distant galaxy, where they discover potential habitable planets. However, the journey is fraught with challenges as they encounter cosmic unknowns and grapple with the effects of relativity and time dilation.
One thing becomes really clear.
Two.
And that's that you want to make sure your children feel safe.
One.
I'm coming back.
When?
I love you forever.
Potentially habitable worlds right within our reach.
Could save us from extinction.
Here we go.
You can't just think about your family. Now you have to think bigger than that.
I am thinking about my family and millions of other families.
Maybe we've spent too long trying to figure all this out with theory. Love is the one thing that transcends time and space.
Do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light.
All right, Enrique!
Yes, you are.
We'll find a way. We always have.